GCC. This is a video for Chem 130 on electron configurations. Now, hopefully, you just watched the atomic structure video. If not, you may want to go and watch that one first. So, we just learned that we put electrons into an atom, into orbitals that are contained in sublevels that are on the levels. And we learned that the first two columns of the periodic table correspond with the S sublevel, because we can put two electrons in an S. So these are S1, these are S2. We learned that this block here is the P block. We can put six electrons in a P. So this is P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6. Not helium, but neon down is P6. Then we learned that 10 electrons can fit in a D, and this block here is the D block because it is 10 wide. And we learned that 14 electrons can fit in an F, and these two rows down here are 14 wide for the 14 electrons that go in an F. So let's go back and look at our fabulous picture we have from Chem 130 textbook about the organization of the sublevels in the atom. And we're going to learn how to put the electrons in. Like, where do we put an electron first? Do we put an electron here in the 3D? Do we put an electron in the 4P? So where do we put electrons? Well, we're going to start with the lowest energy. The lowest energy is closest to the nucleus. So which level's closest to our nucleus? Level one. So we're going to start at level one. So our first electrons that we put into an atom go into 1s right here. We can put two electrons here. Where do you think we're going to fill in next? You're correct if you said 2s. Yeah, we're going to put the next two electrons in the 2s. Where do we fill in next? Yeah, in the 2p. We can put six electrons in the 2p. Where do you think we're going to fill in next? You're correct if you said 3s. So we're going to put two electrons in the 3s. And where do we want to fill in next? Yes, 3p is next. And now we got something tricky. Where do you think we're going to fill in next? Remember, we're filling in by energy, not necessarily location. So you may have guessed 3D, and actually that's wrong. We're going to fill in the 4x nest next. It is lower in energy than the 3D. So even though the D is closer to the nucleus on the third level, there are five orbitals here. Think of that as like air conditioning a five-bedroom house. Your electric bill is going to be a lot higher than just a one-bedroom house. Even though we're out on level four, this little orbital has less energy than the 3D. So I actually go to the 4s, put two electrons in here, then we go back to the 3D. So to summarize, we fill in our electrons. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, back to the 3D, and that's good enough for Chem 130. You know, we can figure out the rest of it later in Chem 151. So that brings me now to this order. What I just said, 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, and etc. We'll worry about that later. So I want us to write electron configurations for these atoms. Let's start out with a magnesium atom. Let's find magnesium in the periodic table. What number is it? It's number 12. What does that 12 mean? Protons. That's the number of protons. But if it's an atom, 12 is also the number of electrons. So magnesium has 12 electrons. So we're going to put 12 electrons. So we can put two here. We can put two here. That makes four. We can put one, two, three, four, five, six here. That makes 10. And we can put two more here, and then we're out because we only have 12 electrons anyway. So for magnesium, how we write that is 1s contains two electrons, so 1s2. The 2s contains two electrons, so 2s2. The 2p contains six electrons, so 2p6. And then the 3s contains two electrons, and we're up to 12. 2 plus 2 is 4 plus 6 is 10 plus 2 is 12. That's because we have 12 electrons total in magnesium atom. So that is our electron configuration. We just fill in till we run out of electrons. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. All right, let's try oxygen. How many electrons does oxygen have? Let's find oxygen. What number is it? There it is. It's number 8. That means 8 protons. And if it's an atom, it means 8 electrons as well. So we only need to fill in up to 8. How many go here? 2. What about here? 2. So how many are going to be in this 2p? It's not going to be full with 6. It's going to have 4 in there because that makes 8. So oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4 because we have 8 electrons total. Oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. 2 plus 2 plus 4 is 8. Good job. Okay, I want you to try phosphorus on your own. Go ahead and pause right now. All right, so phosphorus, let's find it in the table. What number is it? Number 15. So 15 protons, and if it's an atom, it means 15 electrons. So we're filling in up to 15. So that's 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. That should be 15 electrons total. 2 plus 2 is 4 plus 6 is 10 plus 2 is 12 plus 3 is 15. Good job. All right, so that's how you do electron configuration of atoms. I'm going to go ahead and tell you how to do ions, and this is something you'll want to come back and revisit, but you may have learned already, it depends on when you're watching this video, that atoms like to gain and lose electrons to become ions. So here's some ions that we have. Cl likes to be a minus one charged. So let's figure out how many electrons that is. Let's look at our periodic table and find Cl for me. It's number 17, very good. So chlorine has 17 protons, always and forever, and an atom has 17 electrons, but this is not an atom. The negative one charge means we have an extra electron because it's negative and electrons are negative, so there must be one more electron than protons. So that means instead of 17 electrons, we actually have 18. So we need to fill up to 18 electrons, 18. So that's 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, because we have 18 electrons in a Cl minus ion. Again, the negative one charge means we have an extra electron. It gained an electron, making it go from 17 to 18. Who else has 18 electrons? Well, if we look at our periodic table, argon also has 18 electrons. So this means Cl minus one ion is isoelectronic with argon. Isoelectronic with argon. Meaning they have the same number of electrons. Perfect. Now let's try calcium plus 2. So calcium plus 2, calcium, let's find it. Number 20. So it has 20 protons always and forever. The atom has 20 electrons. But what does plus 2 mean? If it's positive, it means 2 electrons went away. So it lost 2 electrons. So we started out with 20, 2 were lost, that means we have 18. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. 2 plus 2 is 4 plus 6 is 10 plus 2 is 12 plus 6 is 18. 18 electrons. Wow, that's the same as Cl minus. And the same as argon. They're all isoelectronic with each other. So this is the same. It is also isoelectronic with argon, Ca2+. All right, let's try Na+. Sodium. Let's find sodium. Number 11. Very good. So 11 protons, and the atom has 11 electrons, but sodium plus 1 means it lost an electron. So it's actually down to 10. Let's fill in up to 10. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 2 plus 2 is 4 plus 6 is 10. We're done. 10 electrons for sodium plus. Who else has 10 electrons? Let's look. Number 10 is neon. Neon has 10 electrons. So this is isoelectronic with neon, meaning same number of electrons as neon. And the last one, Al+, or plus 3, same thing. Where's aluminum? It's number 13. So if aluminum has a 3+ charge, means it has 3 more protons than electrons, meaning 3 electrons went away. Okay, so instead of 13 electrons, it only has 10. So we're only going to fill up to 10. It's 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 2 plus 2 is 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 electrons. Wow. It's the same. It's isoelectronic with neon, which is isoelectronic with sodium plus. So that's how we do electron configurations for ions. Remember, if it has a negative charge, we've actually gained electrons because electrons are negative. So we have more electrons than protons. If we have a positive charge, then there's more protons than electrons, so electrons were lost. Okay, we lost electrons. All right, I hope that video was helpful for you. Keep studying and good luck.